In the previous session, you have learned about the role nutrition plays in our growth and development. You have also studied autotrophic mode of nutrition with example of photosynthesis process in plants. Please go back to the previous session on nutrition in case you have to revise the basic concepts before proceeding further. In this session, we are going to focus on understanding heterotrophic nutrition and various modes of heterotrophic nutrition. Heterotrophic nutrition. The word heterotrophic is combination of two words, hetero plus trophic. Hetero means other and trophe means to nourish. Thus, organisms which depend on other organisms directly or indirectly for their food or nutrition are termed as heterotrophs and follow heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Let us consider a few examples. Have you seen cows or buffaloes grazing farms, grasslands or fields? These animals eat grasses or leafy portions of herbaceous small plants. All plants are living things or organisms. As explained in previous session, plants follow autotrophic mode of nutrition. The cattle animals that we just mentioned in our example depend directly on these plants for nourishment as they eat or consume plants and parts of plants. Thus, all cattle animals are heterotrophic. Now, let us consider animals like foxes, snakes, crocodiles, tigers, and lions. We know that these animals hunt and eat other animals like rats, frogs, pigs, rabbits, deer, sheep, cows, etc. as their food. Thus, animals directly use other animals as food are heterotrophic. What about humans, you may think? We eat variety of foodstuffs, breads, chapatis, dosas, parathas, butter, curd, milk, cheese, ice cream, honey, sugar, jam, pickle, eggs, fishes and seafoods, meats, etc. Let us consider bread. Is it organism or living thing? Of course, it isn't. Bread is prepared from wheat flour, that is atta, water and yeast. Wheat flour is obtained from grinding wheat grains, which are basically seeds from wheat plant. So, you see, when we eat bread or chapatis or parathas, we are depending on wheat plant for our food. Another example that we can discuss is milk and various products obtained from milk like butter, curd, cheese, etc. Are these living things? Again, the answer is no.
I'm sure all of you know that we obtain milk from animals
like cows, buffaloes, sheep, goats, etc. Fruits, vegetables, spices, herbs and oils we use are obtained from plants, while eggs and all meats are obtained from animals. This means that we too depend on other organisms for our nutrition and hence we are heterotrophic. In other words, it means that heterotrophic mode of nutrition refers to processes employed by all organisms which cannot use simple inorganic substances from air, water and soil to synthesize their organic nutritive substances and hence depend on organic materials from other organisms for their nourishment. Now, let us take a closer look at various mechanisms of heterotrophic nutrition observed in organisms. Holozoic nutrition. This word is also a combination of two terms, holo meaning whole and zoic means relating to animals. This mode of nutrition is commonly observed in most animals that we see around us. These organisms obtain nourishment by ingestion of foodstuffs either in solid or liquid form. Ingestion of food is simply termed as eating. Thus, all organisms that eat food are holozoic. Holozoic organisms follow a stepwise sequential process for obtaining nourishment as follows. Ingestion. Intake of food material, solid or liquid, into the body of organisms through opening, termed as mouth. Digestion. Conversion or breakdown of complex food matter into simple soluble organic nutrients. Absorption. Transfer of simple soluble organic nutrients obtained by digestion of food to various parts of the body, mostly by blood or similar body fluids. Assimilation. Utilization of absorbed nutrients by various cells and tissues of the body for energy production, growth, repair and development, egestion, removal of undigested food and waste matter from the body of organism. Holozoic organisms can be grouped into following categories. A. Herbivores. Animals that directly use plant matter that is part of plants such as stems, leaves, flowers, fruits, seeds as food. B. Carnivores. Animals that use other animals directly as food. Predators are usually carnivorous animals that hunt and kill other animals for food. C. Omnivores. Animals that use both plant and animal matter as food. Detritivores or scavengers. Animals that feed on dead bodies of animals and plants to obtain their food. Can you group animals from the list below into one of the categories that we just discussed? Dogs, frogs, sharks, parrots, sparrows, pigeons, pigs, crows, goats, cows, lizards, ants, honeybees, spiders, earthworms, hens, ducks, humans, cockroaches, mice, squirrels, houseflies, grasshoppers, snakes. Now, let us study about other heterotrophic modes of nutrition. Saprozoic or saprophytic nutrition. Some organisms do not eat but rather directly absorb soluble organic nutritive chemicals from dead and decaying matter of plant or animal origin. In this case, heterotrophic mode is termed as saprophytic or saprozoic nutrition. The most common saprophytic organisms are fungi like yeasts and molds. Apart from these, many bacteria and some protists are also saprophytes. Due to the action of these heterotrophic microorganisms, decaying plant and animal matter undergoes further chemical decomposition and gets converted to simple organic and inorganic mineralized form. So, such microorganisms are also termed as decomposers. Parasitic nutrition. Certain organisms grow on the surface of or inside the bodies of other organisms by using their body fluids or cellular contents as food to obtain nourishment. These organisms are termed as parasites and they follow parasitic mode of nutrition. I am sure you have heard of insects like lice, fleas and ticks which grow on skin, furry or hairy parts of the animal bodies by sucking blood from the blood vessels present below the surface. These are termed as ectoparasites, ecto meaning out. There are some organisms which grow in internal tissues or organs such as liver, spleen, intestines, blood and lymph vessels etc. of animals, for example liver flukes, hookworms, tapeworms, pinworms, ascaris and microorganisms like Plasmodium
trypanosoma.
These are termed as endoparasites, endo meaning in. The organisms from whom the parasites derive nutrition are termed as hosts. Parasites are always harmful to the hosts. It is interesting to note that few plants which lack photosynthetic pigments also exhibit parasitic nutrition. Can you find examples of such plants? That brings us to the end of this session. Let us quickly revise everything that we have covered. Concept of heterotrophic nutrition and explanation with examples. Various mechanisms or modes of heterotrophic nutrition such as holozoic, saprozoic, parasitic. Steps involved in holozoic nutrition. Different categories of organisms having holozoic mode of nutrition, namely herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, detritivores. Can you answer the following questions? Difference between autotrophic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Which part in the body of an organism helps in ingestion process? What is the difference between scavengers and decomposers? Herbivore, animals that eat plants, thus dash, animals that eat insects, dash, animals that eat fruits, dash
animals that eat grains.
What is the difference between predators and parasites? In case you have difficulties in answering any of the simple questions, I suggest that you go through the session on nutrition in living organisms again and also read the chapter in your textbook thoroughly.